But let's say you think you can get to quarterfinals, and you actually get there. What are the chances, if you win, of winning the semis? What do you think? What do you think? What are the chances? I was looking at you. Yeah. What are the chances? If you believe you can get to the quarters, but that's only where you're supposed to go, what are your chances of winning the semis? Yeah. That's exactly right. That, and what he said was that you, if you believe that you're only going to go to the quarters, and then you're so happy you won that game, to get to win in the semis is going to be really, really difficult. Okay? So what you believe is more important than what is objectively the case. So when I asked the team, the first time I met with the team, I said, do you guys believe you can beat any team on any given day? And they said, and we talked about this. They said, yeah. I go, so you're telling me you guys believe you can beat any team on any given day? And they were like, yeah. I go, let's win the whole thing. And they were like, right. Right? And so what's the advantage of that? You start thinking like a champion. You start practicing like a champion. You start believing that you can win the whole thing. So the quarterfinals is just a stepping stone. I believe I can do this. I can believe, I believe I can succeed in life, right? I believe it, so therefore I can do it. If you don't think you can get A's, you won't. I guarantee that. You have to believe that you can do it first. You have to believe that you can be the starter. You have to believe that you can go to Syracuse. If you don't, you will not act like it. One of the things that I say all the time to my clients is, you have to think like an All-American first, and then you become one, not the other way around. Does that make sense? You have to think like an All-American first, and then become one, not the other way around. Why not? Yeah. Yeah. If you don't think you're going to become one, you're not going to become one, because you've created so many limitations that it's so hard to become All-American just to start with. Right? I think most people think, oh, I'd be confident too if I were All-American. That's not how it works. How'd they get there? By playing confident, by being confident. There's something called self-efficacy, which is you don't have to be the most confident person in the world, in yourself, but you can have self-efficacy, which means you believe that you can accomplish a task. So if you're a little shy or you're a little insecure with yourself outside the field, believe in yourself on the field. You can compartmentalize that. I believe that I can stop a ball from anybody. That's what the best players in the world have. And you can start to think, just choose to think like that.